The if function in Excel allows you to create a conditional formula which does one thing if it's true or another if it's false. The easiest explanation is an example. So here I've got bank balances, some positive, some negative. Depending on whether they're positive or negative, the bank either gives us 8% or charges us 12%. To create an if function, we click on the function wizard, we go to if, and you'll see it asks for three items. First, it asks for a logical test, then what must happen if it's true, what must happen if it's false. In this case, the logical test here would be to please look at the bank balance over here, and is it bigger than zero? So that's the way we ask Excel if a number is positive. If it is bigger than zero, what must it do? Well, it must be positive, therefore we only get that amount. And because we know we're going to copy it down, I'm just going to put the dollar signs on. If this number is not bigger than zero, then it must be a negative, and this is the amount that we're going to be charged. And again, I'm going to put the dollar signs on. Let's just see what happens. So it looks at the 100, sees it's positive, and gives us 8%. If this number was maybe minus 50 now, it immediately knows that it's now a negative number, and it uses the 12%. Let's just look at the if function again and just make sure we understand certain key components. So the first part is this logical test. It is very important that there's a test here that you as a human being can answer true or false. We often see this situation where people just point to a cell and they don't tell Excel what it must do about that. So typically a logical test will always either contain a bigger than, an equals to, a less than, or one of those functions. Could be a bigger than, an equals to, could be a less than, an equals to, etc. But generally speaking, there's always a cell reference or a number on one side, a bigger than, equal to, or less than in the middle, and another number or reference on this side. So let's go back to the bigger than zero. The value, if it's true, can be anything. It could be a number, so we can just type a number in there if we want. It could be a word, but we must remember to put inverted commas around it. Or it could be what we had previously, which is a reference, and you just need to think about the dollar signs. When I say OK, we get that, and just to complete this, we copy it down, and you can see it correctly gets the amount. And what we would typically do then is bolt our calculation over here, take the balance times the rate, and we'll get our numbers.